We spoke about knowledge transfer, and we spoke about baby boomers leaving the workforce, whether by choice or, however. What I also want to understand, being provocative in my thought, is do you think some of that is also led by their own doing in of not innovating, so to speak? Obviously, you mentioned about the gaming industry and looking at different skills and expertise, bringing them into that ecosystem. And it's really interesting you mentioned that.
Okay, the Netflix performance, share performance of the last 1 year.
Yeah. I mean, do we think that part of the problem is the senior management team in not innovating fast enough and allowing change? Or is that just the structure of what has been a legacy and has just continued to be, the can being kicked down the road, so to speak?
Yeah. It's much easier. I hope you will like this analogy. It's much easier to turn a sailing boat than to turn, a huge yacht, a huge boat. Yeah. So it's. I think that I don't think that there is an issue with senior management not seeing the future or not seeing the truth or not wanting to do it. But it's you are dealing with what you have. Okay. And you need to change the changing the direction of a such an important group towards something new, towards something that is upcoming, let's say, it's a much harder effort than if you have a small company. Okay, so I think that the competence. Let's, as I said before, marketers want real value. Okay, you cannot. This group are not delivering a sub. Service. So, what they have to do is trying to figure out how they can capture that opportunity that the market is presenting with the competence that they have. It's all based on competencies. Okay. I mean, if I'm a real serious gaming expert, okay, because I develop games day in, day out, and I want to learn from others that are good at this, okay, I probably will go into a company that does only this. Okay. I'm not going to go to a company that does a lot of other things. Okay, so that's a challenge, which is the fight for resources, the fight for competencies that for some time for the groups is harder to is harder to acquire in general, just because those guys that want to work with their peers, and their peers are mainly in those startups that I was mentioning. That's why
And the
the
cost of acquisition is totally different to
I was
the
saying, yeah.
traditional media. So I completely get that. I think the biggest challenge is that cost of acquisition and getting your head around it. But that requires a new state of thinking, I think, and I recently put out there, is it better to invest when the market's going up or going down? Or does it not really matter if you have a strategy and a plan, a strategic strategy and plan, because then you will invest in that strategy as opposed to think about the acquisition cost of just, let's say, the headcount, if that kind of makes sense. I don't know your thoughts on that. I mean, what's your belief system in terms of that?
I believe that if your Cartesian axis strategy is clear, okay, and of course that's a living animal because it needs to change with with the change of the trends and with what's happening, then you need to be faithful to your strategy. One thing that I witnessed in my career is that the let's say the There is a, there is there is a, there is there is a bullet out there, okay? And the bullet is if you start changing rapidly things, then that's when basically you start folding the not folding, but you start suffering as an operation, okay? Because then people will leave you because they don't understand what is going. The talents are create maybe business are not directly related to talents, but if management defocuses from the business of clients in order to retain talents, it's a machine. Okay, it's like a chain. Sorry, that's the word I was looking for. So I would say that stay faithful to your strategy. Develop the evolution of the strategy in order to meet the opportunities. Keep in mind that, and this is really quite a difficult to believe, but One of the business that you would expect to be the most dynamic, the most innovative, the most changing is the communication business, right? But if you look at the where the rate of change of those groups and the advertising agencies and so on, you can see that it's hard to change into those groups, okay? Because we have done things in this way and this is the way things are done. So there is sometime you can feel a disconnect between the young generations that are entering the marketing operation, okay? They work with marketers and maybe, you know, a way of doing things which is still into those groups or into those large agencies. In reality, and you can see this by the performance of the individual units within within the group, some understand this and they are fast, they capture, I think, on Bunderman, very successful, okay? Because they are capturing that opportunity, they are operating in a very contemporary manner. Some maybe less, okay? Whether they're WPP or not WPP, doesn't matter, okay? So it's all about stay faithful to the strategy and make sure that your operation is agile to capture the opportunities that are out there, okay? That's it. And be good at attracting the right talents. It's all about talents. You know, you will be successful with marketers if you have the right talents on board. Marketers don't buy a name. They buy the professional skills that the company can bring, the competences.
So you've kind of answered my question there, which was around about moving forward, how will investors and board need to start strategically thinking about their operating model that perhaps they weren't before, and what will future methodologies look like? Is there anything you would add on that perspective?
No, it's more, as I said, I mean, if you look at the boardroom is clearly looking for advancing the business and making sure that, you know, volume and margin are kept in the high tens, I would say, okay, if you are in those type of groups, otherwise in the high 20s if you are in others, okay. So the reality is that I think they need to land on the understanding, they need to land commonly, the management and the shareholders, on the understanding that partnering with marketers at this stage is it means buying the ticket for the future, okay? Trying to acquire, to manage profit at all costs, acquiring more margin in this stage, maybe, you know, a ticket for a different type of future, okay? So I would say that it's all about, as I said before, managing the operation as efficiently as possible in order to maintain the volume. And obviously with a strong eye on the margin, of course, but you know, if you have to sacrifice something, don't sacrifice the volume, sacrifice the margin at this stage. It's much harder to regain the volume than the margin.
You mentioned something really interesting earlier around the drop being about 11 to 20%. So how would something like a COVID have impacted the cost base, and what does that do to profitability in the sector in the face of declines?
The 11.8% decline, the revenue decline. Is that what you are referring to?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So the, you know, clearly is I would say is driven by the COVID situation. So lots of clients have you know, have suffered. I mean, think for example of you know, in the fast moving consumer goods. Okay. Just an example. In the fast moving consumer goods, think of the milk category. Okay. So the milk category, most of sales are done through bars or patisserie. Okay. So, you know, with those shops being closed, you know, on and off, they have lost significant market share, for example. They pulled investment. So they, you know, and like this, a lot of other companies, airlines pulled completely investment. They can't fly, okay? Travel industry and so on and so forth, okay? So clearly that has impacted, as I said, on the revenue and is significantly impacted on the margin. I don't have the numbers. I don't know. That's private information to those that manage those numbers. But I can expect, being my experience, that there has been a significant impact on the margins, on the margin of operation, okay, of those operations. So it's that's why I was saying the volume is important to retain, because you need time to adjust the operation and the structure in order to become more agile. Agility is the name of the game in the future. And agility can only be achieved not only through, of course, a reduction of the layers that you were mentioning, but also through a new way of working, new methodology, new flows, okay, which those large groups are injecting in their operation. But clearly it takes time, because we're talking about thousands and thousands of people. Okay? So That's a fact. That's what the future will entail.
Please, guys, don't forget to like, share, comment, and we'll see you on the next video. Thank you very much.